Hey guys, it's Lucky Girl B, and this is Colony 13, Season 3, the final season. So, it was brought to my attention that some of you are new to this channel and may not know what Colony 13 is. So, let me catch you up and do a little recap of the first and second season. So, first, we have our original survivors: Mel, Felix, Nora, Parker, Sarah, Mason, and Jillian. When we start season one, we find our survivors abandoned by the military 2 years after the outbreak of the zombie rage virus. Parker, a scientist and bioengineer, could always be found trying to find a cure for the zombie rage virus. The group survived a harsh summer and a harsh winter. During this time, they lost Felix, Nora's husband, who was bitten while wandering outside. Because the virus spreads very fast, he turned almost immediately, and it was up to Mel to put him down. Sadly, this happened just after finding out that Nora and Felix were expecting their first child, Felix Jr. As the months passed, she found solace and comfort in Parker. Their friendship became romantic, and he ended up marrying Nora and caring for her son as if he was his own. While out looking for supplies to last them for the winter, they found Solomon. Solomon had been living in an abandoned junkyard all by himself. The group decided to take him in. Him and Mel also fell in love and later got married. After their compound was overrun, the group felt it was best to move. When we end season one, the group is finally leaving the military compound. When we pick up with season two, the group, however, is not faring as well. Facing very little ammo, another harsh winter, and small living spaces and very little food, the group was in desperate need of help. Parker, who had been trying to make contact with anyone for months, finally got a message on his radio. A voice promising the group that there was shelter and food at a compound not too far from where they were, but they had to travel on foot. As the group was making their way to this unknown compound, they found an abandoned car repair lot, which had been taken over by a gang. The leader of this gang was Grayson. It was obvious from the start that this guy and his group were shady and that this was definitely no place for decent people. But in the middle of a snowstorm and zombies lurking, the group had to take their chances. The two groups combined and went out scavenging for food and water, where they found an old man who had been shacked up in his house for months, but surviving well with tons of food. Grayson killed him. Colony 13 was obviously horrified, and this was their cue that they need to leave. Grayson made it clear that he had no regard for human life. As Colony 13 tried to escape, they held Sarah's sister, Jillian, as hostage. Sarah, outraged by the fact that a grown man would try to kidnap and hold for ransom a little girl, Sarah shot and killed his right-hand man, Isaac. Jillian was able to escape with her sister, and Colony 13 was back on the move. When Colony 13 finally arrived at the Pax compound, they were so relieved to find that they were finally somewhere safe. The Pax survivor group consisted of Winifred, Paul, Mercy and Fahim, Milani, Pooja, Calvin, and Barney. Life was good, but it wasn't for long. Grayson had been following them, and he wanted revenge. He blew up a car in their lot in the middle of the night, which alerted a horde of walkers that were nearby. Colony 13 was able to defend themselves, but not without loss. When the dust had settled, they saw Barney had been shot. Barney, also a very scientific man in his own right, had been trying to help Parker discover the cure for the zombie rage virus. So here we are with our favorite survivors 2 years after the Grayson incident. Things have been relatively easy for the group, but things are getting harder. The compound's harvest suffered after a bad summer. Now food supply is running low, and the group must decide if they are ready to go out and venture farther for food. So without further ado, here is the first episode of Colony 13, Season 3, the final season. Winifred, I know you don't agree with me, but it's important that we go on this scouting mission. Well, Mel, what do you think? Well, I don't just think it's important. I think it's mandatory. Our food supply isn't going to last forever. Mel's right. If the food gets much lower, we won't survive the winter. We have to go. Even if it's just a small group of us, we need to see what else is out there. If you all really think this is best, then I guess we have to do this. Great, so now we have to talk about who do we send. No, of course not. I would never allow that. I think it should be myself, Sarah, Paul, and Calvin. I think Parker and Solomon should stay here. You don't want me to come with you? Are you sure about that? I mean, what if you get to a scrape out there? I would feel more comfortable if I went with you, honey. Well, I would feel better if you were here. Then I would know that this place is being taken care of. That the young ones are being taken care of. With Paul gone, you'll need a sharp eye on that roof. Well, what about Mason? He could be a lookout. No, that boy has not proven himself. I'm sorry, but I have to agree. Mason can't go. I don't think that's exactly fair. Mason needs a chance to prove himself. Yes, he's young and he's slightly immature. Slightly immature? That boy can't even be trusted to garden. He would kill our crops faster than pick an apple from the tree. Well, I think we're decided, so I guess this meeting is adjourned. You guys will leave tomorrow morning. If you guys are done with your meeting, breakfast is ready. Great. Whatever you guys whipped up in there smells really good, too. Winifred, can I please talk to you? I know Mason hasn't proven himself. I wouldn't trust him outside either. Oh, I'm sorry you heard all that. I didn't mean for it to be that loud. Listen, I'm not worried about that. I want you to send Jillian out there with me. You want to risk your sister going out there? Are you sure that's a good idea? I mean, she's the same age as Mason. Listen, I trust Jillian out there. Mason isn't as reliable. I know that. He's my brother. But my sister's not like him. She's careful. She'll watch where she's going. So it's up to you. Can Jillian please go with me? We need another scouter out there anyway. Okay, if you think Jillian is ready for it, fine. She can go. Thank you. This is really important to me. No problem, Sarah. I'm gonna go call them in to eat now. Hey, boys. Get away from that garden. Those apples are not for you. Hey, guys. Breakfast is ready. How's everything coming along, Fahim? Ugh, not so good, Sarah. I don't think these apple trees are going to hold out much longer. Fahim is such a pessimist. The garden's doing just fine, Sarah. I don't even think there's a need to go out on a scavenging hunt. We'd be fine if we just stay here. Hey, Mercy. Okay, so give me the real deal. How are things going? Not good, Sarah. I wish I could go out with you guys. Yeah, we're picking more weeds than we are fruit, sis. Ugh. So it really is bad, huh? Yeah, I would say so. So, how did the meeting go? I actually think it went really good. I pleaded my case with Winifred, and she said she's willing to let you come out with us on the hunt. This is your chance to prove yourself, so you can't screw it up. You can trust me, sis. Me and Mason are going to do great out there, I promise. We won't mess it up. No. Mason cannot go out there. But why not? Listen, I know Mason, okay, he's a screw-up, but come on, sis. No, I'm not putting the whole group in danger for Mason. You understand, right? I guess so. Ugh, you're growing up so fast, I'm so proud of you. Thanks, sis, and thanks for believing in me. Of course, now let's go eat. Okay, I'm starving. Ugh, so chore time's over, thank goodness, because I'm starving too. Let's go. Okay, everyone, breakfast is served. Come eat. Okay, everyone, don't crowd around the food. There's enough for everyone. Oh, we're so lucky we still have that grain. Yes, but it won't last forever. If you guys don't mind, I would like to talk to the group that's going out on the scavenging mission tomorrow. I think we should go over a list of the things we'll need. Clearly food, medical supplies. Yes, the medical supplies is getting extremely low. Well, we're gonna start the hospital. That should have everything we're looking for. Are there any other places to scout in the surrounding area? No, unfortunately, everything's been picked clean. The hospital's our best bet. I'm hoping there'll be supplies to help with my research. I still haven't given up on it. Research, you mean your failed attempt at a cure? Give it up, Parker. We're not going out there to save the world, we're trying to save ourselves. We shouldn't give up on that hope. Finding a cure would save us and the world. The cure was not that far of reach when Barney died. Do you really think there's hope for a cure? Parker says it's possible. I'm not so sure. We have to be realistic about the situation. Once you're bit, you change. You don't come back. You're right, but it can't hurt to try and stop the cycle. Just make sure you all get back safe, please. We will. It'll take a few days to get back, though. And when we come back, we'll come back with food and supplies. Well, that's good enough for me. Okay, fine by me. I gotta get out there to the field. Yeah, I gotta get back on that roof, too. Wait, I'll go with you for a bit. You just wanna make kissy faces with your boyfriend. Your sister's got a point. Oh, shut up. Ladies first. Hey, I'm no lady. Oh, don't I know it. Ah, oh, the sun feels nice. I'm glad you're coming with me tomorrow. I'm so glad Jillian's finally gonna get out there. I can't believe you're so excited about this. It's important that she starts learning the ropes. I mean, I won't be here forever. Sarah, don't say stuff like that. I don't want to think about losing you. And I don't want to lose you, but we have to think realistically here. If we're always out there, the chances of something happening to us just increases. You think I don't know that? So if the younger ones know how to handle themselves out there, it makes things easier. So if they start becoming more capable out there, we'll have more people, more eyes, more hands to carry supplies. We live longer. It only makes sense. I wish Mason could go out there, but I know he can't be trusted. And I can't have him being the reason someone ends up dying. I would never get over that guilt. I feel the same way about Mercy being out there. I mean, she's still my baby sister. When my dad turned, I swore I was gonna make sure she never did. And I've been keeping that promise. I don't plan on breaking it anytime soon. That's how I feel. I'm just so glad I have someone who understands me. Glow shrooms, sodium chloride, benzene, oh, sulfuric acid. No, that'll never work. Damn it. I'm so close, I feel it. There's just something missing. What the hell is it? Think, Parker, think. Maybe, no, that's just stupid. No, that would just speed up the death process. Maybe? No. I wish Barney were here. Honey, you mind taking a break? Sure, I always had time for my favorite girl. What's up? You had your head in that book all day. Aren't you hungry? You didn't even eat. I'm sorry, hun. I'm so distracted. I just don't have the time. I really feel like I'm close. Something just missing. I just don't know what it is. You need a break, though. You need to sleep. You're not going to be able to help anyone if you run yourself down and make yourself sick. You need a break. You're right. I promise. I'll take one in an hour or two. I'm not just doing this for me, Nora. I'm not doing it even for science. I'm doing this for everyone. If I had figured out the cure, we wouldn't have to put down Felix. Felix Jr. would have his father. There's just so much I wish I can do, but I can't. I just don't have the brain power. Never thought I'd be saying that. What happened to Felix was not your fault. It wasn't my fault. It wasn't anyone's fault. It's just the way the world is now. The dead walk, they bite, and then you become one of them. That's just the way it is. And Felix does not feel the loss of a father. He has you, and you're amazing. But I'll never really be his father, no matter how much I want to be. Believe me, Parker, you're enough. You don't have to save the world. So, did you talk to Sarah? Yeah, she wasn't buying it, Mason. Sorry. I don't get it. Why doesn't she trust me out there? I don't know. She said you're too immature. She's such a butthead. I'm not immature. You just called her butthead. That's like the ultimate sign of immaturity. Well, how am I supposed to learn if she never gives me a chance? It doesn't make any sense. It's like trying to get a job, but you need job experience. See, Mason, there you go. Still thinking the world is the same place it used to be. It's not the same thing. If someone gave you a job and you screwed up, so what? Big deal. They fire you. They replace you with someone new. You go out there. You get cornered by walkers. Get someone else killed. And then there's another lurker walking around. It's totally different. Whatever. It's time for bed anyway. Let's go. Oh, Mason, don't be such a crybaby about it. Hey, guys. Curfew time. Everyone in. Lights out. Yeah, we know. We're going. Jillian, is everything okay? Oh, sure. Everything's fine. He's just upset because no one trusts him out there. But I'm stoked to go out there. And I promise, Winifred, I'll prove myself. Don't worry. I do understand why Mason's upset. And honestly, I do feel he does deserve a chance. Maybe just not on a scavenging trip this long. I mean, you guys are going to be gone for a few days. Maybe we'll start him out on a shorter one. Something that only takes a couple of hours. Work his way up. I'll see what Mel says about it. Yeah, that sounds fair. Night, Winifred. Well, it looks like you're all ready to go. Be safe out there. Wait, please. Give me a chance. Take me with you. Mason, no. I'm sorry. You can't come with us. You can't stop me. Ah, what got into him? I'm gonna go talk some sense into him. He's already slowing us down. Mason, what is wrong with you? You think after the stunt you just pulled, I'm really gonna let you go with us now? Why don't you trust me? I'm the same age as Jillian. You're not on the same maturity level, Mason. That's the problem. I'm never gonna get there if you don't give me a chance to do anything. I can't trust you out there, Mason. You hold people's lives in your hand when you go out there. Do you understand that? Of course I understand that. I'm not an idiot. Stop treating me like one. You have all this faith in Jillian, and you have none in me. You just think I'm some big screw-up. I don't know what I did to make you think that. I can be just as brave and just as tough as you or as Jillian or anybody else. I can be useful. You need to stop treating me like I'm still a little kid. Maybe you can go on the next run. Maybe. But this one is too important. I can't have you screw it up. I don't understand. What is this about? Is this about Dad? We don't talk about that. You know that. It's not my fault how Dad died. I know he went back into the house to get me. But it's not my fault. I was a kid. I froze. I should have ran out when he told me to, but I just couldn't. I said I don't want to talk about it, Mason. The fact or not, if it was your maturity or the fact that you were a kid or that you froze, whatever it was, the point is, Dad died because he went back in there for you. And you couldn't just do what he told you. I can't have you going out there and freezing like that again and getting someone else killed. I'm not going to have that on my conscience when I could have prevented it. You guys, have you come to a decision? We're wasting daylight here. Well, I don't know about you, but I came to my decision. He's not going. Maybe they're right, Mason. Maybe you should just stay this time. Listen, if the kid wants to go, I don't mind staying behind. You can't be serious. You would trust him out there? Would you really let me go? No, we wouldn't let you go. Paul, back me up on this. Please. I don't know. I don't see the problem in letting the kid go. He needs to learn. Well, I don't like this idea, not a bit. But the kid's really that determined to go, then I guess he can go. You guys are serious about this. Okay, fine then. Okay, Brat, so you're getting your way. But I'm going to be stuck to you like glue, you hear me? Fine, fine. So we better get going. We already wasted the better half of the morning. Yeah, she's right. We better go. Come on. You stick to my side as if we're conjoined twins. You hear me? I don't want you out of my sight for a second. Come on. What's the worst that could happen, sis? Don't even ask that question. I was just making a joke. Come on. Let's go. I'm ready. Are you guys coming? Yeah, we're right here. Okay, fine. Let's go. Hopefully we can find a car and then we don't have to walk there the whole way on foot.